Good afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Thursday. We have our second installment, second segment of my interview with Richard Moss, the author of Inside Out Healing. He's going to be talking about eliminating fear, letting go of fear, so you can actually get on and do the things that you want to do in your life. Very powerful stuff. Check it out.
Say someone is in constant state of fear of failure. Okay, something like, failure is a good example. A lot of people feel like they're going to be failure. And it is obviously affecting their overall health. It's affecting their lifestyle. Is that feeling real? And how do you, and if it is, you know, how do you deal with it in order to make it either go away or to work with it? You know, I want to kind of get a concept of how you would address feelings, how you get out of them, or how you, like, kind of be with them, so
yeah.
Someone can understand, like, how to use a process like this to actually feel better.
There's stages that people go through in order to develop a more balanced consciousness so that they can address feelings like failure. I do most of my work, Kevin, in retreat, and in my retreats, which last anywhere from just a weekend, which are short ones, or 10 days long, what I'm trying to do is have each person have a feeling of really grounding in the body, grounding in the present moment, and feeling not just an ordinary state of well-being. It's what I call radical aliveness, a deep sense of aliveness. And if you've had that feeling, and you know that feeling, then you can take a second step, which is a process of insight, and the book is all about how to make those steps of insight. So in answer to your question, is the feeling of failure, or really the fear of failure, real? It's only real because you tell yourself a story that makes it real. It's not real at all without those thoughts. No human being is a failure. We may fail at certain endeavors, but if you fail at an endeavor and you've done your best, you're probably not going to tell yourself a story that you're a failure. You'll simply say, I made some mistakes, I made some misjudgments, I gambled and I didn't win the gamble. Okay, let's see what I can do the next time. And that's no big deal. The point is that we have developed gradually our ability to think. By about the age of 5 or 6, the ego is in full formation. By the age of 7 or 8, we've had 10... maybe 20,000 hours of practicing identification with our beliefs about ourselves, others, the past, and the future. So in a sense, our only sense of who we are is based on the continual arousal, emotional arousal, of the stories we tell ourselves. Now, if you want to become a master musician or a fine athlete or, you know, exceptional athlete, you have to practice. Malcolm Gladwell talks about it in one of his books. The research suggests about 10,000 hours of practice. So when you think about it, we're all absolutely experts at believing the stories we tell ourselves about the past. We're all absolutely experts in believing the judgments we make about ourselves, which go on all the time, all day long, thought after thought. We're all experts at believing the judgments we make of other people, of other countries, of situations, of our jobs, of our careers, even of our bodies. Our stories about God, our stories about money, we identify with these things. We identify and they become our sense of self, and none of that is our true sense of self. And that's the important thing. None of that is our true sense of self. And if you want to free yourself and heal that, then you have to become an observer of what you're saying to yourself. Because you'd have to say to yourself something like, I'm a failure, in order to feel like a failure. You'd have to say, I'm no good, I'm not smart enough, I'm not capable of doing what other people are capable of doing. And as soon as you utter those words or you think those thoughts, instantaneously your body goes into contraction. The contraction has an emotional quality of depression or fear, anxiety. So, and that contraction becomes so constant in most people that they actually think that's who they are, which is as why I said I do my work in retreats to free people from that state of contraction long enough for you to know, oh, that's not who I am. That's not really who I am. And then you need to practice. if you want to be someone like the Dalai Lama, who's probably put in 30 or 40 or 50,000 hours of practice, to become as free as he is, able to laugh. You know, when they asked the Dalai Lama why he spoke so respectfully still of the Chinese, even though they had invaded Tibet and really done atrocious things to the Tibetan people, he said, "I speak that way because I feel better."
Hmm.
You know, and that's intelligence. When you judge another, you judge yourself, because as soon as you say you don't care about me, you feel angry, or you feel sad. Or as soon as you say, this is never going to work, or this relationship is never going to work, that thought creates depression. And then the mind starts to look to the future to find some story that will provide hope. Okay, this relationship won't work, but the next one will. And so we're constantly running away into an imaginary world. Instead of staying right here, really feeling our bodies, really listening, really perceiving our senses alert, awake, colors vivid. And when you're there, it's impossible to feel like a failure. It really is. It's not real. It's only real if you believe it. And the same is true for almost any form of fear. Most of the time, our worst fears are the stories we tell ourselves. So if I say to someone, what's the worst thing that will happen to you as you get older in age? They'll say, oh, I'll die, or I'll be dependent on other people, or they'll say, I won't be able to get around on my own, I won't be able to do the things I love to do. And I say, yes, all of those things may happen, but that's not going to be the worst thing. The worst thing is what you're going to tell yourself. Are you going to tell yourself, my life isn't as good as it was before? Or are you going to be really present, embodied, aware, awake, open-hearted, and no matter what your circumstances, in which case you become a wise elder, and yes, your body may ache a little bit more, and no, you won't be able to run as fast or bend as easily or do the things you did when you were younger, but if your heart is open, then your life is rich. And, you know, the only way for the heart to be open is to be in the present moment.
All right, I hope you enjoyed that. If you didn't notice, today I actually shaved my goatee that I've had for I don't know how many years, but I wanted to just try it. I just did it. And one of the reasons why is because a lot of people were saying, hey, Kevin, you know, you're looking fatter. And I'm like, what do you mean? And Emery said, it's the beard. So my beard was like, you know, making me look fatter. So now I'm instantly skinny. Pretty cool, huh? Your question of the day is this, is if you eliminated all fear in your life, how would it be? Big question. Go ahead and post that down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.